And then the next, how do non-flowering plant that reproduce from spores, yang dari spora bagaimana? Okay, the first we have to know that the spores are small and light, so it is dispersed by the wind. Jadi kalau sudah pasti spora itu small and light, so the dispersals by the wind, pasti disebarkan oleh wind, angin. The examples are fern and mosses. Jadi contohnya adalah tumbuhan paku dan lumut. So the fern and mosses are the plant which is are reproduced by the spore, yang berkembang biak dengan spora. Now let's see one by one. The spores in fern, spora pada tumbuhan paku, in spores bag. Jadi dia ada di kantong spora on the underside of leaf, di bagian bawah daun. So this is the leaf of the fern. We call this is the frond. Kita sebut frond daun tumbuhan paku itu. And then where is the spores? Underside of the leaf, di bagian bawahnya. Jadi kalau daun bagian atas, we can see the underside is are the spores, ada di bagian bawah. And then how about the mosses? Bagaimana dengan spora pada lumut? Mosses grow in moist area. Jadi mosses itu kan tumbuh di tempat lembab ya. The spores of mosses are contained within spore capsules. Jadi ternyata bentuknya seperti kapsul. Dia ada di kapsul-kapsul. This is at the top of the plant, di bagian atas dari tanaman. This is microscopic view ya. Ini jadi ini bisa apa? Kalau ingin lihat the clear view, you have to use microscope. Jadi ini microscopic view, dilihat pakai microscope. The spores of the mosses that the shape like the capsule, seperti kapsul begini ya. This is at the top of the plant. Okay. That's all, my student. The last section just now we have studied how non-flowering plant reproduce. They can use the seed that we call gymnosperm, and then also they can use the spores. The last sections of the unit 2, so it's mean we have finished all the unit 2, and then see you next week, my student, for your task. After this you can do some question, you can answer some question in the Google form that I will send. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.